You play Prudence in this.
Yes.
Very interesting role because we don't know her sexual orientation to begin with.
Right.
Now, what did you think about playing that?
What did I think? I welcomed it with open arms and ran to do it. I mean, it's not every day you get offered to do something like this, and it's pretty amazing, yeah.
Well, and tackling songs like this that people love and have loved for generations, I mean, that's kind of a weight on your shoulder, too. Did you feel that at all?
I would say yes and no, but because... No, because my song was the one song that's really drastically different. So I didn't feel like it was going to be really compared. Yes, because it is so drastically different. And then I knew there'd be people who'd be really upset, you know, with the way that it was changed, you know.
I can imagine this is a movie that when you get the script actually looks nothing like the finished product. Is that true?
Well, what was the script? Just the basis and the ideas was good enough. And then you get Julie in the room and her talking about it is just like, she's like, oh, TV, I have a vision of you. You're going to be body painting and Buto paint, and you're going to be dancing all these grotesque movements, singing Jagaroo Deva, and you're going to fall in the water with these masked ladies, Vietnamese ladies, when Joe is shooting down all the Vietnamese ladies in Vietnam. I'm like, okay. That was day one of shooting. I was body painted nude on a 3x3 platform in the middle of a lake, dancing and singing Jagaroo Deva.
You'll probably never have a more surreal experience in film than that.
Probably not, but I hope I will, because I this is what I live for, you know.
And people love working with Julie. What is it about her that she brings as an actor for you?
Well, I can only speak for myself. I don't know about other people, but Julie has this thing where you have to go down the rabbit hole with her. You have to be willing to dive and help her create her vision, help her realize that amazing, stunning vision that we may not be able to see, but we get convinced when she tells us. We're like, yes, we're there. Tell me what I need to do. Roller skate? Fine. With a horse puppet, of course, it'd do. Yeah, okay. Like, you know, so.
Are you a huge Beatle fan going in?
Honestly, I wasn't, because I had friends in school that would, you know, do things they're not supposed to. And they'd listen to that over and over and over and over again. I was like, la, 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 I can't listen to this anymore. But when I got into it, I didn't actually know the wealth of their music. I only knew, like, that one or two songs. And it's kind of sad, because my stepdad is a Liverpudlian. I've lived with him since I was 3 or 4, and I still didn't really grow up.
You should know this.
Right?
No. You should have been born into it. What's next for you?
Well, I don't know. I mean, well, I don't know if I'm allowed to say. It's something with Julie, hopefully, coming up, but... That's
going to reunite a lot of the cast in her next project, you think?
Some of us. I'm not really allowed to talk about it yet, but I just came off of something, so I haven't been able to really go. I was injured for 3 months. Yeah, I was doing Rent on Broadway, and I got knocked, clocked in the head.
Oh, that's not good.
And I had, like, a concussion, and, like, all this, and, yeah.
You're okay now?
Yes, I'm fine.